Guys, let us quickly look at the treatment for juvenile nasopharyngeal angiofibroma. Okay, we have already in the previous video seen what exactly it is. So basically in the nasal cavity posterior, you will have this angiofibroma growing, and it can it's a benign tumor of the nasopharynx. It's very common, right? So basically what happens in this is there is a in young boys, because of testosterone, there can be a mass that grows at the back of your nasal cavity, which can grow into the nasal cavity, in the nasopharynx, and also into the pterygopalatine fossa, right? And laterally, it can go to pterygomaxillary fossa, temporal fossa, etc. So exactly what is happening in these adolescent males, because of testosterone, there can be a hamartomatous nidus of vascular tissue in the nasopharynx, right? So this is how the gross is when they have removed it. And you can see this is a dilated blood vessel in the fibrous stroma. Right, so this is this bleeds easily. So these blood vessels which are there, they will be just endothelium lined. They will not have elastic or muscle coat, so they don't have the ability to contract. So they'll have severe bleeding. Just on touch, there will be bleeding. So these people will have recurrent epistaxis. Okay, so basically, what will you see? Recurrent epistaxis, because of which they can be anemic. There can be nasal obstruction. There can be this obstruction of the eustachian tube. All this we have seen in the details in the previous video, right? So there can be hearing loss, otitis media with effusion. You can see the nasopharynx and the mass in the nasopharynx. There can be swelling of the cheek. There can be this frog face deformity, and even cranial nerves can get involved. You know, it can grow into your cranial fossa. So it is kind of dangerous. So basically, you should not do biopsy here because it will bleed. So otherwise, what will you do? You will order CT scan, in which you will see antral sign or the Holman-Miller sign, which is the pathognomic feature of angiofibroma, that is the anterior bowing of the posterior wall of the maxillary sinus. Then you will do MRI, then carotid angiography to know which the feeding artery is, so that you can do embolization of it before the surgery. Then you will also keep blood ready in case there is severe bleeding and blood loss. This is showing bone destruction. So this angiofibroma leads to bone destruction, right? So basically, where does it arise? Posterior part of the nasal cavity. Close to the superior margin of the spinopalatine foramen, right? Then it grows into the nasal cavity, nasopharynx, and into the pterygopalatine fossa. Then laterally, it can grow into the pterygomaxillary fossa and the infratemporal fossa and the cheek. So these people can have swelling in the cheek, right? All this we have looked at in the previous video. So extensions of where and all you saw, from nasal cavity, paranasal sinuses, pterygomaxillary fossa, infratemporal fossa, orbit also it can go, proptosis, frog face deformity you saw. So basically it can enter via the intra or inferior orbital fissure. It can destroy the apex of the orbit. It can also enter via the superior orbital fissure. Cranial cavity also it can enter. Anterior cranial fossa, it can enter via the roof of the ethmoids or the cribriform plate. Medial cranial fossa, it can enter directly by eroding the floor of the medial cranial fossa, or indirectly it can go via the spinoid sinus or the sella tersica. All this we have seen in the previous video. Now we have to just move on to the treatment, right? So treatment, what will they do? They will surgically excise this mass, right? So because otherwise radiotherapy, chemotherapy, hormonal therapy, etc., you can control the growth of it. But treatment of choice is surgical excision. Okay. So basically, there are many ways of surgical excision. Transpalatine you can go. When will you go transpalatine? When it is there in the nose or the nasopharynx, transpalatine is sufficient. Endoscopic also again via the nose. So this is only when it is small, right? It is still in the nasopharynx, nose kind of a thing. Then if you want a little more bigger opening to remove this mass, you can do transpalatine with sublabial, that is below the upper lip. So you can go, this is called a Sardana's approach. Okay guys, there is a table here which says exactly how to approach this mass in the nasopharynx. If this mass is there in the nose and the nasopharynx, you can just go transpalatally or endoscopically. This is enough. But if it has gone into the pterygopalatine fossa, or if it has entered the sinus, maxillary antrum, you will have to do lateral rhinotomy with medial maxillectomy. You will have to do maxillectomy because it has gone to the maxilla, maxillary antrum. Or you can do endoscopic or Lefort 1. Lefort 1 is this line here. Right, all these, I think this is more like a fracture, right? But anyways, they're mentioning that name here, thinking it's the same thing. So lateral rhinotomy means what? Somewhere here, lateral rhinotomy, right? So they will cut here and they will go, then they'll have to do medial maxillectomy. They'll have to go break the wall of the maxillary antrum also, looks like, right? Or Lefort 1, they'll have to break this bone and go, looks like. Okay, so all this, if it has gone already to the pterygopalatine fossa, maxillary antrum, Then what if it is also has gone to infratemporal fossa? If it has gone to infratemporal fossa, what you do? Lateral growth, it has gone to infratemporal fossa. Then you will have to do extended lateral rhinotomy. So lateral rhinotomy itself extended, or infratemporal fossa approach. So you have to go into the infratemporal fossa, or maxillary swing approach. Okay. Then next, let us look at this. Are we going too fast, people? Let's look at this. If it has also cheek extension, right? It has come to your cheek, right? The cheek has swollen. Now, what do you do in this case? Then what you will have to do? You can do. Where are we? Here. Cheek extension, if it has happened, you will do lateral, extended lateral rhinotomy, same thing. Okay. Then here. Intracranial, it has gone here. Intracranial, it has gone. That is anterior cranial fossa, it can go, or middle cranial fossa. Then what will you do? You will have to do combined intracranial and extracranial approach. You will combine both intracranial and extracranial approach. Craniotomy plus one of the extracranial approaches. So both the sides from intra and extra, they are going, looks like. Okay, then a residual or recurrent disease. If there is a recurrent angiofibroma, you will observe. You will repeat the surgery, or you will give radiation if it is inaccessible. Inaccessible what? Or radiation if inaccessible. If it is inaccessible by surgery, is it? Okay. Then intracranial, residual or recurrent. So intracranially, it is something is remaining or it is recurrent. Then you'll do stereotactic radiation. They're going X or gamma knife. Okay. Radiation itself, they're giving for recurrent cases, looks like. Okay, so this is the treatment. Here, what did you see? Transpalatine. Transpalatine plus sublabial, which is Sardana's approach. This you have to remember. This has a specific name, right? So, this is below the upper lip, they will also cut. Upper lip, labial is what? Lip. Lateral rhinotomy, you saw this with medial maxillectomy, but this will leave a scar. You saw, right? Lateral rhinotomy. So, there is via facial incision or degloving approach. What is this? They haven't explained, it looks like. But anyways, remember this. What they are doing here is facial incision. See, degloving actually is also called as avulsion. Severe injury that happens when the top layers of your skin and tissue are ripped from the underlying muscle. Okay, this looks quite, you know, harsh. Endoscopic removal. Transmaxillary Lefort 1 approach. You saw that one, right? Do you remember? This one, transmaxillary Lefort 1. Lefort 1, they are saying, you know, when it is there, maxillary antrum and pterygopalatine fossa extra. It has reached there. Now look at this, maxillary swing approach, facial translocation approach, or V's operation. What is this V's operation? Something like this they are showing, guys, maxillary swing approach. Or they are going infratemporal or fossa approach, or intracranial, extracranial approach. When will they do this? Infratemporal fossa, when it has gone to infratemporal fossa. And cheek also, right? Intracranial, extracranial, when it has gone to the cranial cavity. See, infratemporal fossa approach, when it has gone to infratemporal fossa. Then if it has gone to cranial cavity, then you will do this intracranial, combine intracranial and extracranial procedure. So basically, first thing you saw, they have mentioned is transpalatal approach. If it is there, where? In the nose or nasopharynx. But if you want, and the tumor is extending laterally, you can go sublabial, right? And add sublabial sublabial approach, and that will become Sardana's approach. Then they are also explaining transmaxillary Lefort 1 approach. Transmaxillary, right? That you saw the photo. Transmaxillary or Lefort 1. The textbook is also explaining this maxillary swing V's operation, right? So here they are saying osteoplastic flap with entire cheek and maxilla is raised as a single unit and later reconstructed. You saw the photo, right? Facial translocation. This one, maxillary swing approach, facial translocation approach, V's operation. If it is intracranial extension, you can easily remove with extracranial approach, but if it is intradural or cavernous sinus is involved, then you'll have to take the help of neurosurgeon. So pre-operatively, they have to embolize, remember, so that it will reduce the blood supply and cause less bleeding. Okay, and within a few, within 24 hours, like that, they are saying of embolization, you should do the surgery. Otherwise, collaterals will develop. Okay. Then, how will you find out where to embolize? By doing preoperative angiography. You will know which the feeding vessel is, right? So, if you know which the feeding vessel is, that one you can embolize. Correct, guys? So, you will do preoperatively, you will do angiography. So, this is before embolization. This is after embolization. So, then only you will know who is feeding. Right? Angiography will tell you who is feeding so that you can do embolization so that you can reduce bleeding. Management of recurrent tumor. You will observe the tumor. It may spontaneously regress or you have to do revision surgery, remove it. Radiation you can give because radiation will reduce blood supply. But you know that radiation can cause, radiotherapy can cause malignancy in later life, right? So radiotherapy is primary mode of treatment. They are saying tumor will regress in about a year, but there is risk of development at a later age. So that is why this is controversial, radiotherapy, okay? Then, hormonal therapy, this is because of testosterone. So they are giving estrogen here, diethylstilbestrol, which is non-steroidal estrogen. But this, remember, was causing vaginal cancer in the female offspring. But here anyways, you are giving it to a male, looks like it's fine. Flutamide is an androgen blocker. Flutamide, don't forget, okay? Then chemotherapy, you can do vincristine. All these will actually arrest the growth of the tumor. That's it, guys. So we have looked at in this video the treatment for juvenile nasopharyngeal angiofibroma, JNA. That's all for now. Bye-bye. Guys, for surgery, you saw that there are so many approaches, right? Just remember when they say lateral, right, they have to come through this lateral, what was that? Rhinotomy, right? So they want to go here and then they want to do maxillary maxillectomy, etc. so that they can reach this mass. So you can just kind of understand what they are trying to do if you understand this diagram, right? So this is the mass here, let's see. So transpalatine will tell you, right? So this is soft palate. You can see soft palate. So transpalatine, you will have to go. Right. If that much space is not enough, they want to go superior labial. That is Sardana's approach. So all this you can understand.